PCL ligament, that is posterior cruciate ligament, is the widest, strongest and less likely torn ligament of the knee. Let's talk about the main ligaments of the knee so that we can emphasize the structure and the function of the PCL ligament. So this is a model of knee joint, and if you see that this is the bone of the thigh, that is called as the thigh bone or femur. This is the bone of the leg, which is called as a leg bone or tibia. We have four ligaments in the knee. The ligament on the inside is called as the medial collateral ligament. The ligament on the outside is called as the lateral collateral ligament. If we talk about the ligament on the front here, this is called as the anterior cruciate ligament. And now we'll be coming to the most strong ligament of the knee, and this is called as the posterior cruciate ligament. So this is the view from the knee from the back side, and if you see, here is the most strong ligament of the knee, which is located, and it is located exactly at the back of the knee. This ligament is around 32 to 35 millimeter in the length. It arises from the posterior part of the tibia and attaches on the inside of the knee, that is the medial femoral condyle. This ligament is made up of two bundles. The larger bundle is called as the anterolateral ligament or the anterolateral bundle, and the smaller bundle is called as the posteromedial bundle. The anterolateral bundle is twice the size of posteromedial bundle and is stretched in flexion, whereas the posteromedial bundle is tight or stretched in full knee extension or in a full knee straight position. Friends, PCL ligament, as I told you, is a very thick and strong ligament, and it is rarely ruptured. The ratio of an ACL injury versus a PCL injury is 10 to 20 is to 1. So it is a relatively less commonly injured ligament of the knee. But this injury is particularly more common in Indian subcontinent owing to a presence of large number of two-wheelers. The injury is more common in two-wheeler accidents, specifically what is called as a dashboard injury, in which there is a direct hit on the tibial surface from the front. So whenever there is a direct hit on the tibia from the front, the ligament is stretched on the back, and you may have ligament injury and ligament which is torn from the back. Also, you can have this injury in other motor vehicle accidents, specifically if you have any hip fractures, hip dislocations, you may have a posterior dislocation of the knee along with a PCL injury. As far as the sports are concerned, this injury is more commonly associated with a high velocity sports like football, American football, rugby, skiing, etc. When we talk about the grade or the severity of the injury, this injury can be divided into four types. Type 1 is an injury in which only some of the fibers are injured. Type 2 or grade 2 is about half or 50% of the fibers may be injured. Type 3 is a complete PCL ligament injury, and type 4 is a PCL ligament injury along with other ligament injuries. So this is a form of a multi-ligament injury. PCL injuries are often a part of KD, that is called as a knee dislocation. There are different types of knee dislocations, and usually a PCL injury is an important component of knee dislocation injury. Knee dislocations may be associated with vascular injury, and whenever there are knee dislocations, it is imperative for the surgeon to check the posterior circulation and check if there is a good flow in the vessels or not. As I told you, the ligament is on the posterior aspect of the knee, and the ligament is in close association with another ligament which is called as a meniscofemoral ligament or ligament of Humphrey or ligament of Wisburg, and these ligaments usually arise from the posterior lateral corner in vicinity of the lateral meniscus and attach in a close vicinity of the PCL on the medial femoral condyle. Now, technically speaking, the function of a posterior cruciate ligament or a PCL is to prevent the posterior translation of tibia. That is, that the tibia or the shin bone doesn't go posteriorly or backwards because of this strong and stout ligament. So whenever there is an injury in this ligament, the tibia will go backwards. So your shin bone or the tibial bone will be pushed backwards or will fall backwards if there is an injury to the PCL ligament. So let's talk about the main physical examination findings in case of a PCL injury. Firstly, you will develop a posterior sag. So in posterior sag, we ask the patient to bend the knee to the 90 degrees, and while doing so, the tibia will be sagging backwards, and that will lead to a posterior sag sign positive. Also, you can have a posterior draw test positive, which means that the tibia is falling backwards, and whenever you press the tibia will go backwards, and this is called as a posterior drawer test positive. You can also have a Clancy sign which is positive, which essentially means that there is a loss of tibial step off because of the PCL injury. And lastly, you can have a test which is called as a quadricep active test, in which this is the upper tendon, this is called as a quadricep tendon, and when you try to contract this tendon to bend or extend the knee, the tibia will move forward. So that is called as a quadriceps active test, and which is also a sign of PCL injury. Now many patients ask us, how can we identify that we have a PCL injury? So first and the foremost, you should have a strong history of injury, because PCL usually don't happen with a small or a trivial trauma. Normally that is a large or a major episode of injury, maybe a two-wheeler accident or a motor vehicle accident or any other accident which may cause a posterior cruciate ligament injury. Also, there may be pain. Now this pain can be moderate, can be less, or can be more. And the most important thing to realize here is the pain is not proportional to the severity of the disease. So occasionally large ligament injuries may have little pain, and small ligament injuries may have large amount of pain associated with them. The other important feature is the location. Usually this pain is located on the back side of the knee, and very occasionally it can be seen on the front of the knee as well. You may also have a rigidity in the knee or a feeling of rigidity in the knee, and you may have a restricted knee flexion or knee bending because of the injury. So a restricted knee bending or restricted knee flexion is also a feature of a torn PCL ligament. Also, in some cases you may have a limp while walking, that is when the patient will try to walk, he may fall down or he may walk with a limp, he may walk with difficulty. Also, because of a PCL ligament injury, there is a high chance of developing of patellofemoral arthritis or patellofemoral injury, and if a patient has got a patellofemoral injury after patellofemoral symptoms after any particular injury, then also you should suspect a PCL ligament injury. Now coming to the diameter or the dimensions of the PCL ligament. As I told you, the PCL ligament is about 30 to 35 millimeters in length, and the cross sectional diameter is around 11 to 13 millimeters. The femoral surface area is around 209 millimeter square, and the tibial surface area is around 243 millimeter square. Now we will talk about a predominantly first aid in a PCL injury. all PCL injuries, whenever initially identified, should be treated with a PCL brace. A PCL brace is a specific brace which is designed to treat PCL injuries. The specific feature of the PCL brace is that it has got a posterior tibial support. So it has got a support on the posterior part of the tibia which prevents the tibia from sagging or falling downwards, and that leads to a support of the tibia from the back, and this leads to the healing of PCL in a proper position. Now this brace can be a static brace or a dynamic brace. A static brace means that the brace is straight and the knee cannot move. You can have a dynamic brace, which is also called as a hinge knee brace, in which there is a hinge at the level of the knee, so the knee can move but the posterior tibial support is still there. So whenever the knee is moving also, the patient will have a support on the posterior aspect of the knee, and so there will be less posterior tibial translation and less chances of a healing in a poor position. So a PCL brace is a very important part of the PCL injury treatment, whether without surgery or with surgery. Now coming to the diagnosis of the PCL injury. For the diagnosis of the PCL injury, the two most important tests that we do is an X-ray and a stress radiograph along with an MRI scan. The normal X-ray that we take is an AP X-ray and a lateral X-ray, and we take what is called as a stress radiograph. What that essentially means is we do a posterior drawer and we push the tibia backwards, and we see that how much the tibia go backwards after the posterior drawer. So if it is less than 5 millimeter, it is a grade 1 injury. If the posterior tibial translation is between 5 millimeters to 10 millimeters, it is grade 2 injury. If it is more than 10 but less than 15, it is grade 3 injury. And if it is more than 15 millimeter posterior translation, it is grade 4 injury. That means it is a PCL injury along with other ligament injuries like a posterior lateral corner or a lateral collateral ligament injury. MRI is a very good investigation, and MRI will also tell you about the severity of the injury. But the important point here to note is that MRI is around 90 to 95% sensitive for the PCL injury, and what that means is about 5 to 10% of the patients who have a PCL injury, the injury may be missed with an MRI scan. So MRI can guide you in most of the cases, but may be a false negative in some cases. Now, as I told you, PCL ligament is an intracapsular ligament. It is covered by synovium, and in very, very rare cases, there are chances of spontaneous healing. But this healing is only seen in a grade 1 PCL injuries. So if there is a grade 1 PCL injury, you can consider of a non-operative treatment with a brace. In all other injuries, the ideal treatment is to do PCL surgeries. And we will come to the detail of the surgery shortly. PCL injuries are of two types. One, you can have a PCL injury in the substance, that is the ligament itself is torn, or the second type of injury is the PCL tibial avulsions, in which the PCL ligament is avulsed from the tibial end with a bone fragment. This is a common variant of the injury, and in this injury there is a small fragment which is avulsed from the posterior tibia in this region. And whenever there is a posterior tibial avulsion leading to a posterior sag which is positive, the best treatment for you is to get a arthroscopic fixation. We do the fixation with the arthroscopic pull out technique. With an arthroscopic pull out sutures, we use a specific high strength polyethylene sutures for this fixation, and this surgery has got a very good results in expert hands. If the ligament is torn in between, so if it is torn from the substance itself, the best procedure is to augment the ligament with a graft. So there are many types of grafts which are available. The most common grafts that we use are, number one, gracilis and semitendinous tendon. Number two, you can harvest a graft from the ankle, which is called as a peroneus longus graft. You can harvest the upper portion of the knee, that is called as a quadriceps tendon. You can take a bone patellar tendon, that is called as a BTB graft. Also, you can take grafts from the opposite knee. One graft which is not very popular in Indian subcontinent, but it is very commonly used in abroad, specifically United States, is a allograft. It is also a very good graft. So when I was in my fellowship in US, we used to do a lot of cases with allografts. So this is basically, allograft means a graft of a dead body which is taken and harvested and preserved in a freeze dried or a frozen section. Unfortunately, this is not very commonly available in Indian subcontinent. Now, regarding the technique of the PCL surgery, there are two techniques which are used. The first technique is an inlay technique, and this technique uses an open procedure in which we open the knee from the back, fix the tibia, and then use arthroscopy to fix the femur. Because it is a mini open kind of a technique, it is less famous or less popular. The more common technique is used is an arthroscopic or all arthroscopic technique. Now I will give you a brief overview about my personal technique. I usually do my PCL reconstructions by an all arthroscopic technique using two porters on the posterior medial aspect of the knee. And these porters are very useful because they reduce any problems or complications arising out of the procedure and improve the success rate of the procedure. Ideally, the tibial tunnel should be made as low as possible at the champagne glass drop-off. So if you see here, there is a drop-off like similar to the champagne glass. So you have to make the tibial tunnel at a perfect position of the champagne glass drop-off. So this is a classical position where we need to make the tunnel in cases of a PCL ligament injury. So that is a very important technical tip. In my personal technique, I usually prefer a button on the upper thigh bone. This button can be a fixed loop button or an adjustable loop button. And on the tibial side, I use a double fixation. What that means is we use a disc or a button which is used in an all inside technique along with a screw device. So that makes your fixation stronger and gives surgeon liberty to start mobilization early. We also recommend internal bracing in cases of PCL ligament injuries, and that prevents re-injury, increases the strength of the ligament, and improves the long-term outcome of the PCL ligament reconstruction surgery. Now, I will just give you an overview about the post-operative rehabilitation. The post-operative rehabilitation after a PCL injury is relatively slow as compared to the ACL injury, because the PCL ligament is a more stronger and a broader ligament as compared to the ACL ligament. So we need to put the patients in a PCL brace for a period of 6 to 8 weeks. We usually immobilize the patient for 2 weeks, remove the stitches, and then start the range of motion at about 2 weeks of time. After that, the patient started with the range of motion from 0 to 90 degrees, which is slowly increased over the period of time. Usually, the patient's sports activities can be started after 6 months of the good rehabilitation. A good rehabilitation and good physiotherapist is mandatory for a success of a PCL injury. After PCL injury, a patient should be highly careful because, as I told you, the chances of loosening, re-rupture, and re-tears of the PCL injuries are, or the PCL reconstructions are, much higher as compared to the ACL reconstruction surgeries. The important thing here is, on a technical standpoint, Because of all these reasons, because of higher re-tear rates, higher loosening rates and higher failure rates of the PCL ligament, we do a procedure which is called as a PCL augmentation procedure, in which we don't remove any part of the PCL while doing the PCL reconstruction surgery, and we use the graft as a PCL augmentation. So we put the graft over and above the original PCL which was torn, and we use our graft as a augment to do the surgery for the PCL ligament. So this is a very important technical standpoint that we take care to increase the long-term success of the PCL reconstruction surgery. Obviously, internal bracing has improved our success rate and improved our surgical results a great lot. Friends, if you have any more questions pertaining to the PCL ligament, feel free to write on the comment box. If you have any queries, you can ask us on our WhatsApp number. You can take an appointment for an online consult on our online consultation appointment number as well. Thanks a lot.